Next, making the grade where the pressure is on. Margaret Warner reports from South Korea.
Just outside Seoul, high school freshman Yoo Jae-won gets ready to study. His mom and dad, both doctors, already out the door. Big sister away at school. So that means all the more time to spend with the lovely Miss Lee. Jae-won's virtual teacher leaves this 16-year-old with virtually no time off. And that's the way he wants it.
I think I need to study and work harder for my future.
That's a widespread belief in South Korea, where extraordinary passion for education is the norm. Have we mentioned Jae-won is on his 2-month winter holiday? No matter. He began his day by walking in the biting cold past a billboard touting perfect scoring students to a 90-minute math tutoring session and study hall. The tutoring was at a private cram school or hagwon. From early morning until late at night, 6 days a week, nearly 60% of South Korean youngsters look for a leg up by adding hagwons on top of their public school load. That kind of dedication, some say obsession, has catapulted South Koreans into the top tier of educational achievement. In world rankings of 15-year-olds released last November, South Korean students scored second in reading. American kids were 17th. And they scored fourth in math. Americans came in at 31st.
Koreans have something they call a gyeogyeol, which means education fever.
U.S. Ambassador Kathleen Stevens first came to South Korea in the 70s as a Peace Corps volunteer, teaching some 70 young boys in an unheated classroom.
The passion for education here is part of the Korean passion for excellence. And that is what has given this country such dynamism, such vibrancy, such success, even in the face of very daunting circumstances.
The very first phrase of Confucius' Analects goes, I quote, "To learn and to practice and repeat it every time, every day, isn't this joy?"
Korean society is permeated by values reflecting the teachings of the ancient Chinese scholar, but joy of learning is not the sole motivation.
On the other hand, education is a channel for your social mobility. And if you want to become somebody in society, you want to go to a better college, better school, study certain areas which will bring you higher status and probably higher income.
This hyper-competitive personal drive is what jet-propelled resource-poor South Korea into the top ranks of world economies. From a war-torn wasteland, one of the globe's poorest countries 50 years ago, to the 12th richest today.
Here we have Dire Straits.
Shin Dong-pyo runs the SDP Institute, a hagwon that specializes in teaching English.
Why worry?
For a pretty price.
We have competitive parenting going on here.
Competitive parenting? Explain that.
You see your neighbor's kid speak better English than your kid. You try to figure out what kind of English program he's getting and what kind of kindergarten he's attending. You figure it out and you send your kid to the same kindergarten. That kind of competition going on.
25-year-old Kim Tae-hoon, a student at SDP, says his hard-charging mother had him, even as a young child, attending specialized cram schools every day.
For a 10-year-old boy, that was a big deal, and that was a big pressure for me. Throughout middle school and high school, the burden grew the heavier. In my high school days, I had to go to school in the morning, like 6:20, and school ended up around midnight. So it was, yes, stressed out.
High school is especially pressure-packed. College admission is seen as a make-or-break moment. Scoring well on the national entrance exams means a ticket to a better life.
Is it ever enough?
I just feel like it's just ongoing and never ending, and I have to study more and more, and I have to learn new things. But I never felt it's enough.
Preparing for that all-important college test means rote memorizing, says advanced English student Kim Eun-ji, who enjoyed the give and take of her years in a U.S. school.
In Korea, it's like teacher just saying, you know, just lecturing, and students are like writing and like trying to memorize it and just taking a test. That's all, I think, yeah.
Ambassador Stevens says some Koreans question why President Obama holds up Korea's educational system as a model.
So I have many Koreans who say to me, well, you know, Ambassador Stevens, if you know Korea so well, why aren't you explaining to President Obama that really our educational system is very problematical? Again, the education fever is too high here.
The cost of all that schooling can also be crushing. The average South Korean family spends more than 10% of its income on after-hours cram schools, more spending per capita on private tutoring than any other country. Sadly, with more than 80% of high schoolers going on to attend college, the demand for prestige jobs in big corporations outstrips the market, says Yonsei University economics professor Lee Duan.
All of these 500,000 college graduates are looking for decent jobs. And the decent jobs are jobs in large companies, but those jobs are limited, 200,000 or definitely less than 250,000.
Some 8% of the under 30 set are unemployed, more than twice Korea's enviably low overall unemployment rate. That relentless pressure on students, graduates, and their parents takes another toll.
When young students are lagging behind in their classes, they get blamed by their parents, and they blame themselves. And sometimes they blame themselves so hard that it's going to lead themselves to suicide.
A higher percentage of Koreans kill themselves than in any other country in the developed world. The nation's suicide rate of more than 20 per 100,000 is more than double the U.S. average. Young Yoo Jae-won feels the pressure, even if he scores below his classmates on one test.
I think negative thinking. I'm not really competitive to others. I'm not smart students, or I can't go to a good university.
Does that thought scare you?
Sometimes. If I go to a bad university, I can be ignored by other people.
We really need to redefine what is success. Like, money is not everything.
National Assemblywoman Bae Yoon-hee, who sits on the Education Committee, says something has to be done. South Korea must promote more vocational and other alternatives for its young people, she says, and there needs to be a national conversation about what real achievement is.
We need to rethink our views on success. It is now time for South Korean society to allow diversity about what is successful. Being happy is also success.
By that measure, these kids seem wildly successful. Singing and dancing at songrooms is a favorite pastime here. A way for many young people to blow off steam. Hundreds of thousands of those young Koreans who've come to this lookout over Seoul have left padlocks inscribed with their personal hopes and dreams for a future filled with happiness if they can just take the time to enjoy it.